Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1. Beloved in Christ, living streams of water is 2 years. It is by the grace of God that we have come this far. The Word that was with the Father and the Holy Spirit has become flesh among us, and we are so happy and joyful. For all those behind the scenes, God richly bless you, especially for our benefactors and benefactresses. You are doing so greatly.
Oliver asks for more. Continue on to send us the moment. Continue on to support us with your prayers. Your comments and your encouragement is always welcome.
We want to say thank you to you for making time each and every day to watch the living streams of water. The water that brings us joy, growth, nourishment, and love to each other. I say, God richly bless you.
Na godi.
Asan.
Yedan.
The buyer.
Also, share, subscribe to our YouTube channel and to our Facebook channel. And God will richly journey with us each day. Have a wonderful time.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit, amen. The angel of the Lord declared unto Mary, and she conceived of the Holy Spirit. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Behold, the handmaid of the Lord, be done unto me according to your word. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. And the Word was made flesh, and it dwelt among us. Hail Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the fruit of your womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and the hour of our death. Amen. Pray for us, O Holy Mother of God, that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ. Together we pray. Pour forth, we beseech thee, O Lord, your grace into our hearts, that we to whom the incarnation of Christ, your Son, was made known by the message of an angel, may by his passion and cross be brought to the glory of his resurrection, through the same Christ our Lord. Amen. Beloved in Christ, you are welcome to Living Streams of Water. Today is Saturday after Ash Wednesday, and we'd like to reflect with you with the first reading from the prophet Isaiah. A reading from the book of Isaiah. Thus says the Lord, if you take away from the midst of you the yoke, the pointing of the finger, and speaking wickedness, if you pour yourself out for the hungry and satisfy the desires of the afflicted, then shall your light rise in the darkness, and your gloom be as the noonday. And the Lord will guide you continually, and satisfy your desire with good things, and make you bones strong. and you will be like a watered garden, like a spring of water, whose water do not fail. And your ancient rule shall be rebuilt. You shall raise up the foundation of many generations. You shall be called the repairer of the breach, the restorer of street to dwell in. If you turn back your foot from the Sabbath, from doing your pleasure on my holy day, and call the Sabbath a delight and the holy day of the Lord honorably, if you honor it, not going your own ways, or seeking your own pleasure, or talking idly, then you shall take delight in the Lord. I will make you ride upon the heights of the earth. I will feed you with the heritage of Jacob, your father, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. The word of the Lord. Beloved in Christ, since Ash Wednesday, when we began to listen to the word of the Lord through the various prophets, Joel, Isaiah, the book of Deuteronomy, and others, we come to realize that many of the prophets are calling you and I to a heart that is malleable, to a practice that will show more zeal for us getting closer to Christ, and also for us to know that life, to get closer to God, you need to play your part. In playing this part, the prophet calls our attention to practical things that you and I should do. Today, he speaks of three important things. That is, in the midst of all this, you and I should know that we shouldn't be pointing fingers at people. We shouldn't be speaking about wickedness. And you and I should also be very careful with putting burden, oppression upon people. My dear friends in Christ, do you feel that sometimes the way you go about things are ways that put pressure upon others? You oppress them and they don't know what to do? Or sometimes you feel that it is you yourself who are being oppressed? Take it. Look at life very well and reflect upon yourself. That sometimes the heights that you are, you don't even want somebody to get closer to you. Why? Insecurity. And sometimes you feel that you should be the only one to be where you are because it is indeed your position but no other else. Beloved, can you give that space to people to enter into that particular arena? It may bring a change in your life. It may bring a change in your administration. It may bring a change in everything that you do. Secondly, most of us have high assumptions and we always like pointing fingers at people. Sometimes the way we even assume of what they do, you ask yourself, is it really the case? My dear brother, my dear sister, if you have never experienced someone before, and experience here I mean by living with the person before, you can't say much about the person. But what you need to know is that a word of advice, a word of encouragement, a word that will let the person come into him or herself can change everything around. The third, he calls speaking wickedness. Some people, naturally, are always happy when others are in difficulties. And that is something that we need to look at. Oh, I want to see the person begging me, then I'll be happy. Oh, I want to see the person going through some difficulties, then yes, he will know that he cannot do it alone. Oh, I want to see the person go through a form of misfortune. Then at the end of the day, oh, then it means that yes, there is something that he is going through and nobody will come to his aid. My dear brother, my dear sister, don't try to be a sadist. Your words can be a form by which one or two people can change their life anew. So, know that it is always good for you to reach out to people. It is always good for you to see the good of the other person rather than wishing the person evil, rather than wishing the person bad, rather than thinking that without you, the person cannot live. Without you, the person cannot progress. Without you, the person cannot do anything meaningful in life. God knows us true and true. He knows what we can do and he knows what we cannot do. My dear friends, my dear sisters, put your trust in the Lord. Let him be your guide. Let him be everything that you are and have. Let him be that source of strength for you each day. And in his mercy, he will continue to grant you your heart's desire. May the Lord bless and keep you. May his face shed its light upon you and grant you his peace. May he bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Have a blessed weekend.
Like the deer that yearns for running streams, so my soul longs for you, my Lord. Psalm 42, verse 1. Beloved in Christ, living streams of water is to be yes. It is by the grace of God that we have come this far. The Word that was with the Father and the Holy Spirit has become flesh among us, and we are so happy and joyful. For all those behind the scenes, God richly bless you. Especially for our benefactors and benefactresses, you are doing so greatly.
Oliver asks for more. Continue on to send us the money. Continue to support us with your prayers, your comments, and your encouragement is always welcome.
We want to say thank you to you for making time each and every day to watch the living streams of water, the water that brings us joy, growth, nourishment, and love to each other. I say, God richly bless you.
Na godi.
Asan.
Yeda.
The buyer. Tepuhoya.
Akinle.
Also, share, subscribe to our YouTube channel and our Facebook channel. And God will greatly journey with us each day. Have a wonderful time.